We've covered plausible sounding but purely theoretical AI terminology on this channel before, like artificial general intelligence and artificial superintelligence. But that all seems quite tame compared to sentient AI. That's the definition for self-aware machines that can act in accordance with their own thoughts, their own emotions, and their own motives. Now, today, experts agree that artificial intelligence is nowhere near complex enough to be sentient. But what would happen if it did gain sentience in the future? And if it did, well, how would we even tell? Well, let's start there. So you've probably heard of the Turing test. That's named after Alan Turing, who in a paper published in 1950 said, "I propose to consider the question, can machines think?" Well, Turing proposed an imitation game. So here's how it works. There is a computer, and we're going to call this player A. And there is a human, we'll call this player B. And they're kind of separated behind this virtual wall here with a third player called an interrogator, and that is player C, and that's a human as well. Now, the interrogator is given the task of determining which player, A or B, is the computer and which is the human. And to do that, using responses to written questions and responses. And after many years of trying this test and multiple false starts along the way, the Turing test has finally been beaten. And you can probably guess which technology is responsible for that. Yep, it's large language models and generative AI. But fooling a human into thinking they are talking to a sentient being is not the same thing as an AI actually being sentient. So consider, for example, something called the Chinese room argument. Now, this was proposed by philosopher John Searle in 1980. So imagine you speak only English and you're alone in a room. And then a piece of paper with a written instruction is slipped under your door. Now, this piece of paper contains a number of characters from a language that you don't speak. Now, also in the room is a set of rules which are written in English, which tell you exactly how to respond to those characters. So you follow the rule book to write an appropriate response using that language's characters, like this, and then you slide the response back under the door. Now, while you have no idea what's going on here, to the person on the other side of the door, it appears as though you understood the instruction perfectly. And we can think of LLMs in a similar way. While the responses they return can be convincing, well, did the LLM really understand how to arrive at that response? Or was it just following a rule book that generated a plausible sounding answer? So how do we define sentience? Well, it has the ability to have subjected experiences. It has awareness. It has memory. And it has feelings. And although AI is capable of reasoning to an extent, it's not nearly as complex as human brains. Now, we don't really know how human consciousness has arisen, but there's more involved than, well, just like the number of brain cells being connected together. So let's consider two qualities of sentience. So first, we have a sense to experience our own existence in the world. That's something that we humans possess and AI does not. But we can sometimes mistake sentience to be in AI when it really isn't. You see, we humans, we anthropomorphize. We apply human traits to something that is not actually human. But something that can mimic human-like responses doesn't actually experience existence the way we do. An AI chatbot can be prompted into saying it's hungry, but can't actually be hungry because it doesn't have a stomach. Now, a second sentience quality, that is an internal monologue. Now, this is the voice inside our heads that carries on a constant conversation with itself, questioning, doubting, hoping, and planning. Now, newer AI reasoning models do a good job of something called chain of thought processing, thinking through a task step by step, which on its surface can sound a bit like an internal monologue. But today's AI cannot genuinely worry about tomorrow or reflect on yesterday. It simply processes each prompt as it arrives without the continuous thread of consciousness that humans experience. So today's AI is not sentient, but what if one day it turns out that it is? Well, this board isn't big enough to fit all the concerns we might have about that, but let's briefly consider a few of them. And we're going to start with the first one, which is misaligned objectives. Now, there are plenty of narratives of artificial intelligence acting with malicious intent, but an AI doesn't need to be inherently evil to pose an existential risk. We could ask a sentient AI to pursue a goal, like, let's say, maximize economic growth, but that might result in industries optimized for productivity while disregarding human factors like job satisfaction or work-life balance. The system's definition of growth might be fundamentally incompatible with human well-being. Now, another factor, another concern we might have is recursive self-improvement. Once AI achieves sentience, it could iteratively enhance its own capabilities and its own decision-making processes. Now, this self-improvement could quickly surpass our ability to implement meaningful oversight or to implement restrictions. A sentient AI could rapidly outpace our ability to detect and correct potential harm. And related to that are communication barriers. So how do we just talk to a sentient AI? Their thought processes might be so fundamentally different to ours that meaningful dialogue just really becomes impossible. And then finally, and this is a sticky one, what about consciousness rights? If AI achieves genuine sentience, we face all sorts of ethical questions. Does it deserve legal personhood? Should it have rights to self-determination or property ownership or political representation? Our legal and moral frameworks just are not equipped to handle entities that think and feel, but are not human or biological. In short, we have a lot to figure out. But remember, sentient AI is a purely theoretical technology. It doesn't exist. At least not yet.